My Fit Family is my family.
So you guys ready for a good day today?
We're just a normal family like everyone else, driving the kids to school, making dinners, you know, trying to get the homework done, and still have time for a date night every once in a while.
I like 'em moving, moving.
Our days start probably just like yours. You know, we get the kids up about 7:30 in the morning, we eat a quick breakfast, and we're out the door. You know, we're dropping the kids off at two different schools and off to work. And that's where the fun begins. I mean, our lifestyle from that point of the day on is probably much different than most other people. You know, we're a husband and wife team that work together, live together, raise a family together, and we're just trying to spread that word of togetherness through our word of fitness.
You know, running our own business takes a lot of work. We own and operate, so that means we're responsible for everything that has to be done here at MyFit24. We're responsible for everything. We have to take care of all of the business aspects, but we also teach classes and we do personal training. We have group exercise classes, we have children's classes, we have a 24-hour fitness facility, we also run specialty programs such as dietary counseling and strength and conditioning for athletes.
Well, we created that MyFit Family because we are seeing this major need in the world.
Confusion and chaos. Are those people going somewhere? Why have I never cared?
You know, children are obese. Families are struggling. People just don't know what to do. We can help with the health and fitness side of that.
Love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah.
We know.
Right. So our mission for MyFit Family is to be a resource to help families grow stronger, healthier, and happier.
Now, we've done races similar to this before. You know, we did the Tough Mountain Challenge. We did the North American Wife Carrying Championships last year at Sunday River. And we've done the Shawnee Peak Challenge, which was an event up at Shawnee Peak. All of these were mountain-style races, obstacle courses, but this one is going to be the longest race we've ever done and the most difficult. Our goal with every race that we do is to place in the top 10%.
In this particular race, this will be the most grueling event that we've ever done. And that's still going to remain our goal, to hit that 10%.
We chose the Tough Mudder because it's really tough.
It's a 10-mile obstacle course race. I mean, we're talking ropes, uphill climbs, jumps, and it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, they're estimating that it's going to take over 2 hours to complete, even if you're in great shape.
So that means we need to increase our endurance training,
our strength training,
and our overall anaerobic capacity.
Now, we have a good idea of where we want to go with this and how we want to train, but we needed to do some fitness testing to get some real data and see how to best progress.
Now, sometimes it's not fun to look in the mirror, but that's the point we're at right now. We need to take a good, honest look in the mirror.
You can run assessments on just about anything, from physical ability to nutrition to overall health status.
Be honest with ourselves. We need to take a good hard look and say, what's going on here? Where am I doing well? Where am I doing bad? Where do I have areas to improve? And it really is important that honesty is right out front, that you take a solid, honest look and give yourself the truth, even if it's the hard truth.
We called in for help from some of our top trainers so they could assist us with gathering some measurable data.
Now, doing exercise testing is a really important part of the puzzle.
We completed a series of speed, strength, and endurance tests.
You know, exercise science has come a long way just in the past several years. There are a lot of old myths about physical fitness, about exercise, that really need to go away. You know, we take this very seriously. We put exercise into a science and do it the way it's supposed to be done.
In addition to the exercise tests, we decided to take a functional movement screening. An FMS is designed to specifically pinpoint weaknesses and then assign exercises to correct them. This screening will assist us in creating a training program for optimal results.
You need to get hard evidence, which means getting numbers and empirical data, to see where you fit on the spectrum. Now, once you see where you are, then you can goal set. You can compare yourself to the rest of the field and see where you are according to known standards, and then set your goals to move forward.
Through knowing our starting points and establishing our baseline, we can create training programs that will help us to get exactly where we want to be.
Oh my gosh. So the results are in. We figured out where we stand in the field.
This is a starting point. But we know what our strengths are and what our weaknesses are so that we can best prepare ourselves for the tough mile.
Stacy's strengths were her cardiovascular endurance. She has a very high VO2 max, as well as her lower body strength. And she's excellent endurance in those runs. So that was a fantastic starting point.
And Jesse's strengths are his anaerobic capacity. He can just run like the wind for very short distances. He is strong and explosive, obviously.
So some areas that Stacy needed to improve on was her upper body strength and her overall running form. So she's a very good runner and very good endurance. We need to work on that strength and get that explosive speed up a little bit and raise her anaerobic capacity for those short bursts.
And likewise, you know, Jesse's going to work on his endurance training. You know, I don't know as if he's ever really run more than 5 miles in one shoot before. So this is going to be a long race. Jesse's body, he's designed as a wrestler, so he's got a lot of those short fiber muscles that can just fire away. And I'm basically opposite. I'm one of those long, you know, endurance runners. So it's almost like we found out that we're opposites attract.
Yeah. It'll be interesting, you know, we each have our strengths and weaknesses to see, we each have our areas to work on.
Yeah, we got a lot of work to do.
Let's get to it.
Change is never easy. It takes persistence, commitment, and pushing past that comfort zone.
Critical part of self-assessment is to have the willingness to change and to know that that change is not going to come all by itself. It's going to be a little bit uncomfortable. So take that next step. Here's where I am. There's where I want to be. And it's going to be a little bit uncomfortable to get there. That's okay.
In the health and fitness world, assessment is crucial. As personal trainers, Jesse and I sit down with our clients, look at their health history, their fitness background, and their goals, and assess where they are and where they want to be. This is important to do.
Take the time to do a push-up test. How many complete push-ups can you do before you lose tempo and form? You can try the same thing with pull-ups. How many reps can you complete? Get a timer and some running shoes and measure how long it takes you to complete 1 mile. Take these results as a starting point that you can come back to in a couple weeks and check your progress. Bear in mind that this is just a sample of the few tests that you could take. Contact a fitness professional in your area and schedule a fitness assessment to get optimal results.
Once we have a good look at where you are, you can have a much clearer idea of where you want to be. And that's the point at which you start taking those actions to get there.
In the next episode of My Fit Family, we will tackle the topic of nutrition. We also fall on unexpected fortune when an Olympic champion gives us some advice.
What? Hey, I can't believe we just got an email from the world's best running coach.
Are you serious?
Yeah, check it out.
Oh my gosh.
Follow My Fit Family in our next episode as we get closer to the Tough Mudder event. Can we maintain this level of intensity all the while keeping our family fit, healthy, and happy?
Some people don't have a clue if all of this could be true, but